want to talk a little bit about content creation, because this is something that everyone is talking about right now. How you can make money and how you can also surf on this wave.
Hi, I'm Sira. I was born in an artistic family, and as an agent, manager, and producer, I've worked for many years selling artists from all around the world. Today, I want to help you to become a full-time artist.
Hello, artists. I am Sira, and I'm here to help you to become a full-time artist. I want to talk a little bit about content creation, because this is something that everyone is talking about right now. And when I saw this wave coming, I had no idea about how it will change. And change is the word, because everything is changing all the time. And with all these new things, new technologies, new tools, we start to hear lots of names that actually we don't know exactly where they are. Social media, digital influencers, sales funnel, content creation, those are things that doesn't exist like, what, 10 years ago? And now everyone is doing that. And now everyone's making money with it. What is this? And why? But let's start with the beginning and discover what is content creation. The distribution of information to any media, and most specifically to digital media, for an end user audience in a specific content. Content creation. Okay, great, nice, now you know, right? But what is content again? Content is something that is to be expressed through some medium, as speech, writing, or any of various art for self-expression, distribution, marketing, and or publication. Typical forms of content creation include maintaining and updating websites, blogging, article writing, photography, videography, online commentary, maintaining social media accounts, and editing and distributing digital media. Nice! So it means that content creation is creating some pieces to an audience to deliver a message. Okay, and this is not exactly what an artist does. Well, if you're writing to show a message, you are an author. If you are drawing to show a message, you are illustrator. If you paint to show a message, you are a painter. If you do that with clothes, you work with fashion. If you do that with houses, you work with architecture. It doesn't matter. You are always an artist if you're producing some pieces of something with an artistic feeling for an audience to say something, right? So you as an artist is the first content creator. Aye! Amazing, right? So if you discover that actually you are a content creator before people call content creator, you should be doing that super well, because you were doing that for a while already. But why you are not making money out of this? Well, this is how I'm going to help you. I want to tell you how you can make money and how you can also surf on this wave, because, well, you're already a content creator. The most interesting part here is that when you use the word content and they introduce this content by pieces, thank you, Wikipedia, these pieces needs to be digital. That's what content stands for. If you are producing something in real life, you cannot consider this content with this name. It's just the way that we give names to the things. When you decided that you want to be a content creator showing on internet your work, you maybe need to apply your work to a digital mode. It means, for example, if you're an architect, well, your creation is in real life. Your creation is not digital at all. But you can make videos, you can take pictures, you can show what you were doing while you were doing. And those pieces will be considered content for your work. But if you're a musician, for example, your songs are already digital. Not because now they are in the computer or anything like this. Even when they were in vinyls, they were considered digital. You cannot eat, you cannot taste, you cannot smell. You can consider it digital any type of music, photography, or drawing in the computer. If you have something that is real in real life, like an sculpture, or a real painting, or a dance, then we're talking about real things and not content. However, if you make movies, make videos, you are making content as well. What really changed? You already have cinemas working, TV, radio. So why now people call it content and before they just don't? Well, because we had a major flip in this area. And the most important flip was that now it's so easy and cheap to do that, that you don't need to count on anyone else. Before, if you're a musician, you need to have a label so you can have your music. You need to have a huge studio. You need to have the money to do. And also, the vinyls were so hard to press. You need to have a special machine with a special place. Ah, was terrible. Imagine photography how it was before. You need to reveal this in a dark room with special chemical products. Now you can take pictures with your iPhone. You can make videos with your iPhone. You can record things with microphones connected to your computer and do all the production by yourself. Or even if you have a friend that does that, you can pay like way cheaper than you should pay before for these huge studios with this high-tech material. Also, it was super hard to distribute. So even if you could make everything by yourself, let's say that you were a photographer and you have the proper equipment, you have the proper chemicals, you have the proper room, you work by yourself, how can you show these pictures for a lot of people? It's hard. You need to be on a magazine. You need to go to TV. You need to be in a place that other people can look to your art. And before it was super expensive. Now it's not. Now you can put everything on Instagram and people will see your pictures. Maybe now you can make your movies and put it on YouTube and you can reach people there. And sometimes you can reach millions of people. That will be exactly the same that a cinema would do before. So this is the biggest change. We don't have these barriers anymore. Anyone can produce and distribute for free or with a very low investment. It allows us to be independent. We don't need to have a huge team to do something. Now one person can do everything. And more people are doing everything by themselves. Which means that now we have huge competition. Because if everyone can do, guess what? Everyone will do. And if it's easy for you, it's easy for somebody else as well. It's not that now it's harder. Now it's different. And I see that a lot of people try to play this game right now with the same rules that they were playing the game 30 years ago. I see artists wanting a label to sign them so they can be big. Well, you can be big by yourself. They are trying to find big distributions of movies, galleries, huge publishers to do something that actually it's more accessible for you to do right now. Most of these places are closing doors. So it's kind of hard to count on them to do something that they are not being able to do for themselves. Now, it's important to see that there was a democratization of art. Everyone that has something to say can say that. Everyone that wants to have a movie can have a movie. You don't need to be a director with lots of study. Maybe you can be a housewife that has a message, then make a video and post on TikTok and create connection with people there. Art is the capability to create in another person a feeling or emotion with intention. We're not talking about quality, you are not talking about technique, we're talking about emotion. You can create emotions with a 3-hour movie or with a 15 seconds video. It depends on your message. Messages were never so important in the history of art, because when everyone can do everything, your barrier is not the technique anymore. Your barrier is your essence. And this is something that just you have. You need to invest in your essence. You need to invest in your message. This is the only thing that no one else has. And if you can show this message through your artwork, creating emotions, you are being a very good artist. This connection will bring more and more people around you. They will create a fan base. This will be the community that stands for your unique message. And this is how you start to have people able to buy your things. And if you have people able to buy what you produce, you can be full-time artists, just selling your products and spreading your ideas. The content that you're talking since the beginning will be here to help you to do that. If your art is just based on content, like a musician, you already have a lot of content to work with. However, if you don't, try to use other things to support your idea. Imagine to create a YouTube channel, an email list where you can send newsletters. Think about to create an Instagram showing your message and showing your work. Content creation, it's not a super hard thing. It's just create something with a message within. Be constantly showing this message over and over and over again to support an idea. You already do that as an artist. You just need to adjust your mindset so you can have your mind in a perfect place to be crystal clear about what your message is, and work your structure to deliver this message over and over and over and over again. This is the most important thing for you to surf this wave. You also can be profiting on it. You also can be a full-time artist, as we have full-time content creators. This will give you a very special image. When you have one message to stand for, you create authority to talk about this. And this authority will create your identity that people can connect and understand you. When you achieve this point, companies want to hire you because you think alike. Events want to be there to talk. Other brands maybe want to make collaborations with you and your products, because what you stand for is what they stand for as well.
And it's time to wake up breakfast with McDonald's.
Follow at RuPaul's Drag Race on Twitter to find out.
Whoa, do I smell?
That's right, fondue time.
Big easy reach.
Message is the key, connection is the key. You can create content for that, because doing that, you're just being an artist. Thank you so much for being here with me today. I see you again next week. If you have some questions, put here in the comment section below. But maybe I can help you a little bit better, right? I have a free ebook in my website that will help you step by step. So you can go here in the description of this video, so you can click there. See you. Thank you so much for keeping doing art.